The universe is full of majestic structures, and humans have managed to capture them in images like this. You get the idea. In this video, I'm going to explain the 5 most profound astronomical images ever taken. This list is, of course, my own opinion, and here are some of the rules before we get started. Astrophysicists love graphs, and that's what we aim to make when we point telescopes to the sky. But graphs aren't images, and they're not fun to look at if you don't understand them fully. So there'll be no light curves, no HR diagrams, no gravitational waves on this list. Just great images. This list is not of the pictures that look the best or the ones that have the most scientific impact. As the title suggests, these pictures are the most profound, the most perspective-shifting images astronomy has ever taken, and they'll make you fall in love with astrophysics. So get ready to change your desktop wallpaper. At the number 5 spot of the most profound astronomy images ever taken is the Bullet Cluster. It's gorgeous, but there's so much more in this picture than meets the eye. Quite literally. This picture is one of the most direct evidences of dark matter that we have today. According to our indirect observations and theories, about 5% of the matter of the entire universe is normal matter that we see around us. 68% is something we call dark energy, and the remaining 27% is dark matter. You might have heard that the universe is expanding. Well, for something to expand against a force like gravity, you need to give it energy. For example, when you inflate a balloon, this energy is dark energy. But a much more interesting component of the universe for the public is dark matter, a name we have given to matter that we cannot see. Now, I don't mean things like air. Yes, you cannot see air, but you can feel it, smell it. Dark matter doesn't interact with anything except gravitationally. And that's why it's been extremely difficult to prove that it exists. That is, till we took this picture. In this picture, two clusters of galaxies, both of which contain normal matter and dark matter, are colliding. Now, because normal matter interacts with each other, when it collided, it stopped in the middle. But dark matter does not interact with anything. So when the two dark matter components collided, they just passed through each other. Now, Einstein predicted that where we have more mass, the light will bend more. And when we see how much light is bending in this image, we can map the mass in different parts of this image. Now, if there was no dark matter, there would be only one clump of mass at the center, because that's where all of the gas has accumulated. But because most of the mass is from dark matter, we see two high mass spots away from the center. There's practically nothing that we can see in that part of the image. So this is comprehensive proof of the dark matter clouds that pass through each other. Just beautiful. For the number 4 spot, I have picked this weird looking image called the cosmic microwave background. This particular picture was taken by the COBE satellite launched in 1989. This one picture won the scientists the Nobel Prize. One of the most fundamental questions that humanity has asked is, how did it all begin? Religion, philosophy, and science has tried to answer this question for thousands of years. Did the universe have a start, or did it always exist? The theory of the Big Bang claims that the universe had a beginning. Everything that we see around us was once condensed in a singularity. Then, 13.8 billion years ago, all of it started expanding. The mathematics and physics that follows this theory is able to explain a lot of things that we see around us. The galactic structures, the composition of the universe, and so on. But we didn't have a direct proof of the Big Bang, not until the 1960s. That's when two radio scientists observed a faint signal coming from every direction. This, they claimed, was the afterglow of the Big Bang. Now, this is a bad analogy, but it's easy to understand it this way. Suppose there was an explosion far away. You'd know that the explosion happened because you'd hear a faint sound of the explosion. Add to the mix cosmological redshift and the fact that the explosion happened everywhere around us, and we get the cosmic microwave background. This is the first high resolution picture taken of this background radiation, and to this date, this is the best proof of the Big Bang theory. Since then, the resolution has improved with improved technology in the WMAP and the Planck satellites. This picture is proof that time itself had a beginning. The number 3 on my list goes to probably the most famous images taken by the Hubble telescope. The Hubble Deep Fields. The one you see right here is the first Hubble Deep Field, taken in 1995. Think about it this way. You have the best, most expensive camera in the world, and the second camera in the world doesn't even come close. Obviously, everyone would want to pay you a lot of money to take pictures for them. Every second on the camera would cost a fortune. And just 2 years after owning the camera, you decide to spend 10 whole days looking at apparently nothing. Imagine the uproar, the claims that valuable time is being wasted. That's pretty much what happened. A large patch of sky where there were very few objects of interest was the main focus of the $16 billion camera for 10 straight days. It's difficult to express how bold this move was, but it was so, so worth it. Every spot of light you see in this picture, and there are 3,000 of those, is an entire galaxy with billions and billions of stars just like our sun. This was by far the farthest region of space humans had ever seen. Thousands of scientists wrote hundreds of research papers and articles on this one image, something unheard of in the past. All of this success prompted the scientists to make more observations of the same kind, like the Southern Deep Field of 1996. Then, in 2004, after Hubble was improved, this picture was taken. the Hubble Ultra Deep Field. As you might know, light travels at a finite speed. So, the farther away we look in the universe, the more into the past that we are seeing. Because light that reaches our eyes left these objects in the past. This image sees even further than the deep fields of the 90s, all the way up to the farthest galaxy's invisible light. That is, only about 500 million years after the Big Bang. This picture was zoomed even further in 2012, when Hubble spent a whopping 7 weeks taking this one picture. The Hubble Extreme Deep Field. Yeah, astrophysicists are weird when it comes to naming things. Most of us have seen this picture floating around, so I won't explain much about it. This is the first picture of a black hole. In this case, it's the black hole at the center of the galaxy named M87. Till 2019, we were almost certain that black holes existed. But we had never seen one directly. That was till a team of extremely brilliant scientists and engineers were able to make a telescope the size of the Earth. What they did was, they placed giant antennas all around the world and focused them at the spot where we thought the black hole was. Then, using some extremely clever mathematics, they combined all of these signals into one image that came out seemingly out of nowhere. To explain how absurd this achievement is, the angular size of this black hole is about 42 microarc seconds. That's like seeing a donut that's placed all the way on the moon. Recently, they also imaged the black hole at the center of our own galaxy. This is much harder because our black hole is much smaller and changes very quickly. So, long exposure photography is pretty much out of the question. That required the development of even more sophisticated algorithms to compensate for that. And the most profound image in astronomy ever taken is obviously this. If you don't know what this image is and have watched the video till here, I urge you to keep watching because the next 3 minutes may very well change your life. Like they have mine. The story is, an exploration satellite called Voyager 1 was launched in 1977 to explore the outer planets. After this mission was done, Carl Sagan convinced NASA to turn the camera of Voyager around to take one last photo. This picture has been named the pale blue dot, and the pale blue dot you see in the picture is all of us. It's the Earth. This picture has been recreated many times, for example by Voyager itself in 2020, and by the Cassini probe that went to Saturn. As for why this picture is as profound as it is, nobody can put it better than Carl Sagan himself. From this distant vantage point, the Earth might not seem of any particular interest, but for us, it's different. Consider again that dot. That's here. That's home. That's us. On it, everyone you love, everyone you know, everyone you've ever heard of, every human being who ever was, lived out their lives. Aggregate of our joy and suffering, thousands of confident religions, ideologies and economic doctrines. Every hunter and forager, every hero and every coward. Every creator and every destroyer of civilization. Every king and every peasant. Every young couple in love. Every mother and father. Every hopeful child. Inventor, explorer, every teacher of morals. Every corrupt politician. Every superstar. Every supreme leader. Every saint and sinner in the history of our species lived there on a mote of dust suspended in a sunbeam. The Earth is a very small stage in a vast cosmic arena. Think of the rivers of blood spilled by all those generals and emperors so that in glory and triumph, they could become the momentary masters of a fraction of a dot. Think of the endless cruelties visited by the inhabitants of one corner of this pixel on the scarcely distinguishable inhabitants on some other corner. How frequent the misunderstandings, how eager they are to kill one another, how fervent their hatreds. Our posturings, our imagined self-importance, the delusion that we have some privileged position in the universe, are challenged by this point of pale light. Our planet is a lonely speck in the great enveloping cosmic dark. In our obscurity, in all this vastness, there's no hint that help will come from elsewhere to save us from ourselves. The Earth is the only world known so far to harbor life. There's nowhere else, at least in the near future, to which a species could migrate. Visit? Yes. Settle? Not yet. Like it or not, for the moment, the Earth is where we make a stand. It has been said that astronomy is a humbling and character-building experience. There is perhaps no better demonstration of the folly of human conceits than this distant image of our tiny world. To me, it underscores a responsibility to deal more kindly with one another, and to preserve and cherish the pale blue dot, the only home we've ever known.